While we are on our foot, on our feet, we want to thank God so much tonight. We want to thank God of our Father. What we were praying for, yes, just came to pass.
Hallelujah.
God called a man many years ago. And God said few words to him, fear not, sin not.
Yes.
And from that day until now, we are seeing God everywhere he goes.
Amen.
And we are so honored to have such a man in our midst.
Hallelujah.
Our Moses of our time.
Amen.
God said to the children of Israel, I have seen their cry.
Yes.
I have heard their cry.
Yes.
I have seen their oppression.
Yes.
Now I have come down.
Yes.
Come therefore.
Yes.
God said, come therefore.
Yes.
And he said this, he said, I have come down.
Yes.
But he said to men, come therefore.
Yes.
That means Moses was not alone.
Yes.
God was involved in everything Moses does. We have our Moses tonight in the name of Jesus. We have our Father in the name of Jesus. The name of God. And the name of the apostleship.
Amen.
A humble man made powerful.
Amen.
Put in wells. The whole world is giving into the presence of a man who is in our midst tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, if you feel what I'm feeling, if you are waiting for this moment, I want you to agree with me as we greet our Father and our Mother tonight in the name of Jesus with a Canadian greeting. Let's get excited. Let's get excited.
To see the fire from starting here and here. Wonderful, 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 wonderful. That's only God can do that. Not a man. To do that, if you're a man, you have to have a lot of money. But God has himself. So I'm so happy to be with you tonight. Yes, God has blessed us to give us good administration.
Yes.
So, over the world, I look at over the world, when you hear all the cries, I was invited to South Africa some years ago. They said, we have the preachers here, but we don't have a leader. We don't have administrator. In America, they got that president, new president, and he's shaking America, shaking the whole world. He's not administrator. So any country, the key is administration. That's why tomorrow we're going to talk how it is in the Bible. It starts with it, it says an apostle, then it ends up with administration. You find some scripture says government, some say administration. So, but all of this, with the start of an apostle, the, all the miracle between, but as driven government. Government. To make things move. All was well, but people cry. Remember then, but it was about 70 churches in South Africa. They invited me and said, we have a lot of preachers here. We don't have a leader. Come and help us. Leadership is the key for everything.
Yes.
Leadership. So thank God for this young man who was doing wonderful in the United Kingdom. And God spoke to me and said, this is the right person to go to Canada. And we thank God. To find out, no credits, no, to able to buy tickets for us, no, you people. I know you, all what you are crying, just need the leader. And God gave you one. So we say, you need to look after him and encourage him. So God has blessed his hands with his spiritual wife, this girl, you know, she is a very tough girl. And then she said, oh. Then I said to Misha, are you going to handle that? She's woman. He said, I can't handle that woman. And I saw, like, you are a real man. You have changed this girl. You have changed her. Yeah, we thank God. Her father is a member of Mama Guti. She preached in her father. He became an elder in that area. So we thank God that you have a very good team with a strong woman. So, Canada, your cry, God has answered you.
Hallelujah.
We have your faith in Deeperlife in Canada.
Hallelujah.
We are walking here to bless this prophet and then speak our heart and give us the word of God.
Hallelujah.
And before we go, before we end, by the grace of God, and I used to give someone speak at the morning, but I believe that tomorrow I'll send my son. So if you delay to come, it's up to you. I will speak openly, give us tomorrow by the grace of God.
Amen.
So sometimes, remember, in Europe, we send people, they come late, and so allow someone to speak before, but I think tomorrow, I have to search myself then, because I'm not able to come here to serve sometime. You don't know this church, this ministry, have come very heavy, very heavy. So when you think we are resting, we are not resting. So it's like here when it is dark in Africa, it's not dark, they begin to talk. We began to work in offices and all over the world. So we were busy working all over the world phone. Oh, every 2-3 hours we pray for the sick, for people who have the problem over another country. And God performed a miracle.
Amen.
Oh yeah, that reminds me that girl, that woman when we were in Scandinavia. She was suffering, the dead was, she said, Mama, would you say we are the nation? No, if that big baby in her doesn't change, she's gonna die. And she phoned from Scandinavia. And when she was in queue to go to operation, that trouble, that she phoned and I prayed.
Amen.
And before she arrived there, and she felt that the baby changed. And went to the right place. And the same girl, for her girl, said, I don't know what can I do. This is going to be sick. I don't know what can I do. First, she was crying that she's going to die. Second, she was like, oh, no, God, God, give this God. He performed a miracle.
Amen.
We serve a wonderful God.
Amen.
We serve a very rich God.
Amen.
He told me that if people listen to you, I will bless them.
Amen.
I will bless them. And he said, so Andy, there's a proof we can show you. That yes, if you are a member of our faith and you are listening to the teaching, you never be the same.
Amen.
It's not the teaching of man, it's because he, the owner of the church. This church is not run by man.
Amen.
You can hear some out there. But when things go wrong, it doesn't talk to you, it talk to me.
Amen.
Something goes wrong in Canada, you come and beat me. Doesn't beat you. Doesn't say you don't know.
Amen.
Because his controls His church. So I've come just to love you and to thank you very much that you have, God has answered your prayer.
Amen.
So God has answered you. Just be ready.
Amen.
Just be ready.
Amen.
So I'm here to bless this prophet and bless everything here. Ooh, nice flower here. Ooh. Look, look, look. Now, the administrator says all the equipment are not yet arrived yet. So, the proper piece, I was asking, I said, give me monitor here. I want to hear. He said,
Amen.
That the monitor is coming tomorrow.
Amen.
So, I love you all. I love you with all the love of Jesus.
Amen.
I love Canada. So, we don't know what is this street which we never been. All the streets will be north of streets in Canada and in Toronto. Which streets will be long, coaches, all over. You did talk about Dunder Street and cold, very cold country. Only 3 months warm, 7 months cold. Big country, few people because of cold. But we, God allow us to be here. God said, God, my people, remember, I came here first time when I traveled over Canada. It was among the white people. It was our friends from Cross Nation who organized me to come and around this Canada. That was that time we were able to go to Saskatchewan. That was among the white people. Then time came. We said, oh, I want you to go to your own people, black people. You know what I said when you said so? In South Africa, the same. I was among the white people for many years. They wanted a prophet. They would say, well, come and prophesy. Whether Mandela is going to tell us whether Mandela is going to kill us or not. So I was in South Africa to prophesy. Said, don't worry. Mandela is already going to kill you. So then God spoke to me to go to the black people. Then first I said, the black people, they don't have money. How are going to fly? How going to fly? God said, use it. And God performed a miracle. And big miracles. One woman, 14,000 for me first class, God opened a church in China. What do you think? One person, 12,000 for me to start a church in India. What do you think? Money, black people can pour money. Thousands. Oh, thank God. God bless you. I love you all.